Hello everyone, Daft here with you. In today's video, we're going to generally talk about the EWD, or Engine Warning Display, that's located on the upper E-cam between the captain and first officer. As always, if you like what you're watching and find this informative, feel free to subscribe and hit this notification bell so you don't miss any future uploads. It helps me a lot keeping this channel moving forward. Alright, let's get into it. So the EWD, as the name implies, is basically a screen that shows the status and parameter of the engine control indication, the total amount of fuel on board, the position of the flap slats, and bleeder configuration. That's mainly the top part of the upper E-cam. I'll go into further details about the top portion of the E-cam. To go into details, you see numerous indications and displays shown. You have the N1, EGT, N2, fuel flow, and of course the flap slat position. To start it off, you have the display on the top right on whatever detent you've set your thrust levers. This is the thrust limit mode. If you're at cruise, you would have the display climb, which means that the thrust system has the detent set to climb. A value is given to you as an example here, TOGA. This is a value computed by the FADIC, Full Authority Digital Engine Control, for the thrust lever angle, the TLA. This is the N1 rating limit. Now this might sound too much, but it is informative. The N1 is the low pressure rotor speed. The flight management and guides computer, FMGC, does all the internal calculations to come up with the N1 values when you engage the autothrust, and also calculates the N1 limits. As you can see, the orange tick mark. Now if you take a look at the blue circle donut, those are the thrust lever angle, TLA. In the Airbus, unlike the Boeing, the thrust levers don't move. Once you set the thrust detent to climb as an example, it does the rest of the work and adjusts the N1 percentage as needed for the flight. Lastly, if you use reversers, it'll show rev, REV. The green line or N1 needle shows you what you're actually using from the N1 in percentage, so it'll fluctuate eventually throughout based on the pilot's input. The EGTs, or exhaust gas temperature, gives you a general information on the temperatures and what parameter it's operating in. The green line is what your EGT is actually operating at. Now it isn't abnormal to have two different EGTs against each other, because each engine has its own cycles or use. It's very rare to find an EGT with the same given number. Then you have your limitations, the red arc or max permissible EGT. You don't want to be around there at all. Now the only thing that's not shown or modeled yet in the A32NX is the EGT limit, which is the orange tick mark, or max EGT, and EGT exceedance, which basically is a red line. N2 or high pressure rotor speed is the engine core and is mainly used during engine start. N2 starts turning first, adding fuel, starting the ignition sequence. The values are green, but during startup sequence there's a gray squared background with a green value inside it. Fuel flow is simple. It shows you what your fuel flow rate per hour is given in pounds or kilograms. Last, for the top part, is the flap slat position indicator, very basic. It shows you what the current position is at the moment. On the bottom left is where you'll find what we call memos and warning caution messages. A memo is just a function that provides a complimentary reminder of the current state of the flight. You would have a takeoff or landing memo showing you a list of items that must be done. Now before I get into that, I wanted to talk a few things about how all this is even possible. How is that so simple for a pilot? Well, for the Airbus, mainly full of computers and has protection functions. The benefit of it is that if it detects a failure or abnormality happening, it will display a message to the pilots, making it easier instead of the pilots looking for the problem and troubleshooting from there. It's a very efficient and advanced system at the time when Airbus first introduced the fly-by-wire system. Something that's completely new to pilots that flew using aircraft controls that were mechanically coupled to the aircraft flight control services. That was back then. Really neat stuff. Then of course the Boeing went along with it and implemented the fly-by-wire system to the 777-77, and I believe the 747-8. And also the genius behind the fly-by-wire system for Airbus, Bernard Ziegler, just passed away a few days ago, so Godspeed to him. Alright, I think I've went off topic a little bit. Sorry about that, but something good to share. So back to this again. So the warning caution system, when something goes south, the computer already picks it up and sends a message for the pilot to act on it. The message will show the title of the failure, then follows a corresponding procedure or E-cam actions. A read and do kind of thing. The way it'll look like is that it'll show each failure independently if there's multiple failures at once. Below that failure is the ECAM action or action line displayed in blue. On the bottom right part of the upper ECAM display, if under normal operations are the systems that are currently in use, for example EPU, bleed, lights, park, brakes, etc. Or if you're facing a situation just like this, for example an engine failure, you'll have your ECAM actions on your left and then the affected systems on the right. As you can see, depending on the severity of the situation, it will display in amber or red. Also, if you take a close look at the bottom part of the vertical line, you'll see a small green arrow. This is what's called an overflow symbol, which states to the pilot that there are more actions and items waiting to be completed below. So that's about it for the engine and warning display. Hopefully that sheds some light into some informative. If you have any questions, suggestions, feel free to leave it down in the comment below. Thanks for watching. I'll be seeing you guys next week. Take care.